feel that chill, smell that fresh cut grass. I'm back in my helmet, please to show me that. Standing in the huddle, listening to the call. Fans going crazy for the boys of all. Isn't it just anybody in that club? Took every ounce of heart to sweat and blood. Get the widows, gang their jersey down the hall. Kings of the school, man, where the boys are fall.
Yeah. Thank you. Okay, that box set made of it's completely out of battery. It's flashing. So that might be a... Well, it's still on, so it's not out of battery, so it should be doing something, but I'm gonna put new batteries in. Hello, can you guys hear me?
You can hear me so well. Yeah.
You guys can hear me so well. You guys can hear me so well. You guys hear me? Hello? Yeah. Welcome to the game. Okay, it was a bad time. I don't know how to
I'm gonna go to the bathroom. Yeah. Chicago schools. The schools are members of the Arkansas Activities Association and abide by the rules and regulations as set forth by the associations to maintain and improve high standards of good sportsmanship by their conduct and cooperation with other schools. The high school students performing here tonight are friendly rivals as members of opposing schools. Intergalactic activities and athletics afford each of us the opportunity to support our teams in a positive way for our cheers and encouragement.
Hey! Reese! Hold it! cover the sports, the events, and the news.
Finding a way from the media room to the public.
Hard work and precision is what we strive to capture.
Capturing events in our community for all to see.
We are Airwaves Media.
Thank you.
view slope is lovely. Rear Alma Airedale, number 13, Ben Henley, number 33, Carson Minot, number 54, Mario Gonzalez, and number 61, Matt Cox.
Whitehall has won the toss and will receive the ball to start the football game. Number 10, Caleb Taylor.
third, the penalty on the play.
Sideline warning against Whitehall. That's their first warning. Before the snap, encroachment on the defense. 5-yard penalty, still first down. Before the snap, encroachment on the defense. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
No, that was Nathan Whalen jumping on the outside.
Well, Brother Bob checked in and says there's no echo on the radio. That's not what I'm hearing in the headphones. But
exactly right. So, after three penalties, it is first down and 13 from the 29. And here we go. Shotgun. Bulldogs with the football. Martinez gets a snap, hands off to Buckner, trying the right side, trying to turn it upfield. He's got a couple of blockers, but the containment is out there.
Oh,
he's
going to
be hit for no gain. Alma just kept coming at him.
And, oh, my gosh. Here comes another
penalty flag. And two more flags are thrown. Listen, this is something that Alma cannot do. They cannot give the 15-yard personal foul penalty, but I'm going to wait and see. We had one of them last week. This is going to be a high-spirited ball game. Let's see what the white hat calls.
We've had two plays and four penalties.
Yeah. And it's going to be, it looks like it's going to be against Pine Bluff. Against Whitehall.
Well, one thing I'd like to say, we got a lot of names on the Whitehall, but we don't have any sizes or anything. But I'm just saying that offensive line is somewhere between big and bigger.
You're
absolutely right.
Second down.
I don't know if it's this or what it is, but it's definitely something. Well, they're going to mark. What was the penalty, guys? They're going to mark it off. What we're trying to do is we're trying to work with the headsets to get the headsets to work right.
It's in the mic.
Yeah, it is in the microphone. I can fix this, but it'll be a little bit. The penalty was against the Bulldogs. You're going to mark it off all the way back to the 14-yard line. It's a personal foul. And it'll be first in a couple of acres. First and 27 for the Bulldogs. You know what? Here, do this. Run down to my truck, grab that white box in the back seat, in the floorboard, will you? They hand off, trying it around the end. That's number 11, Robinson. Robinson turns it upfield. He's got a bunch of yards, man. Some good blocking on the corner. And Robinson is going to carry it all the way from the 14 up to the... Where are they going to put this down at? They're going to put it on the 34-yard line. Third down and let's call it 8.
Yeah, that was a big gain right there because they had a long way to go.
Pull that away. There you go. Yeah. Now. Say something now.
How about now?
Perfect. And Pine Bluff, Whitehall is going to take a timeout.
Whitehall.
We're going to take a timeout with him. No score in our game. 9:41 left to play. We'll be back right after this.
It takes hard work to be a Razorback. It takes grit, toughness, and desire. You can't just walk in here and think that you can play for the Hogs. It's not that easy.
I'm being told it is that easy. And you can just walk in and play.
The new Razorback ticket from the Arkansas Scholarship Lottery makes playing for the Hogs easier and more fun than ever. With prizes up to $100,000, it's time you get your ticket and get in the game. Call 1-800-522-4700.
Since the detection of chronic wasting disease, the Arkansas Game and Fish Commission is providing a new option for free CWD testing all season at CWD testing drop-off containers statewide. Chronic wasting disease testing drop-off container locations have been expanded to...
Bulldogs from their own 34-yard line. Back to pass. Martinez looking left. Here comes the pressure. Rushed out of the pocket. Martinez trying to turn it upfield. And Alma collapses on him. Brings him down at the 34-yard line. A gain of only 1 yard on the play. It will be fourth down, and the Bulldogs will be forced to punt.
Yeah, that was a gain. Fantastic tackle by Jonathan Polito.
I think we finally have something figured out here. I don't know what it is, but we have it figured out. So, back in for receiving Grayson Bailey. I'm just telling you, man, when things don't go right, I lose my mind. Grayson Bailey standing back on his own 34-yard line. Here's the punt from Whitehall. A high snap, penalty flag flies. Bailey is going to let it hit at the 35, and it will be downed and touched by a Bulldog player at the 32. But there's a penalty. There was movement by Whitehall. You know, here's the thing. How many penalties did they have? Five.
Well, the thing about it, I saw them out there warming up before the game, and they were even doing illegal motion when they were just warming up.
Yeah. So I'm not...
Illegal motion on the kicking team. 5 yard penalty from the previous spot. 3 play, fourth down.
Well, Alma take this penalty. They're going to repunt it, make them repunt. There's the problem right there.
Well, they probably want Grayson to have a chance to try to get to the ball.
To try to return it. So now Alma will put two back. Grayson Bailey was on the far side.
Connor Stacy.
All right. And Kessler Perdue is the punter standing back on his own 16. Last snap was kind of high. This snap is good. Right footed kicker. Nice kick. He's going to kick it over Bailey's head. He has to backtrack and he fumbles the football.
Ooh.
And falls on it at the 25. The ball was kicked over his head this time as Perdue got off a much better punt. And Alma, even though Bailey fumbled, managed to reel that thing back in and dodged a bullet right there.
Yeah, they went ahead and had them repunt, and they lost about 7 or 8 yards on that.
So first down and 10, Airedales. 8:38, I think we got it rolling down. 8:38 left to play in the opening quarter. No score in our ball game. No, we were late to last week's game because of some wrecks and... Yeah, we're having technical issues. Landon Blair, shotgun formation. Two wideouts, one on either side. And Alma moves and jumps. No, that's on Alma. It's not on Whitehall.
Before the snap. Soft start.
Airedale's
on the offense.
Five-yard
penalty. Still first down.
Some of these teams are acting like they drank way too much coffee before the game started.
Yep, a little too fired up.
Thank you. Thank you, Larry. Larry Breeden coming to the rescue for us. All right, we'll change this thing out at halftime. Thank you, Larry. So, a five-yard penalty on the Airedales. First down at 15. Didn't even get a playoff. Third penalty against Alma. 8:37 to play. There's a snap. Landon's going to keep it. Try the left side. He's to the 20 and hit at the 20. He will only pick up about a half of a yard. And Whitehall had game plan for that. You know, they can see anytime Landon takes a snap, he is going to run to the line and look for an opening. That time Whitehall did a good job of filling those spots with linebackers. And they forced him outside and the pursuit caught up to him. Second down and 14 now for Alma.
Yeah, they're coming out in a four-man front with three linebackers, but they're playing man-to-man out on the edges.
Josh Davis in the Wildcat package. They run Bailey in motion. Davis is going to keep it. A little misdirection. Davis trying to get outside. 20, 25. Davis up to the 29-yard line. A gain on the play of about 8 yards. It will be third down at 6 now, Alma, as the ball will be spotted on their own 29. They have to move it to the 35 for the first down. Clock is running under 7:35 left to play opening quarter. First possession of the ball game for the Airedales. They held the Bulldogs on their first possession, forced them to punt. Now Alma brings in a whole host of players on third down and 6. They have Bailey and Winfrey wide to the right side, trips to the left. Landon Blair alone in the backfield on third and 6. Blair gets a snap, looking, Blair looking, throwing, Blair throwing it underneath. It is caught and complete at the 39-yard line by Bobby Winfrey on a little curl route. Winfrey had to go to the turf goal, though, guys, to reel that one in. That's a good catch by Winfrey, and they move the chains to the 10.
Yeah, I'm having an enjoyable time watching the Whitehall defensive coordinator over here. He's quite animated.
Maybe he needs to stay away from the coffee.
Yeah, maybe they all drank a pot or two on the way down.
First down and 10, Alma. Clock is running, 6:40. They're not in any hurry. They're going to break the huddle at 10 seconds like they've been doing.
Mm-hmm.
Ball is marked at the Airedale 39. Under center, Landon Blair. Two wideouts either side. They give it to Henley. Henley trying the right side. He's hit immediately in the backfield. Gets back to the line of scrimmage and nothing more. Second down and 10, Alma.
One thing I'm seeing, calling the name a lot, is defensive end Chris Fitzgerald, number 54, just a sophomore, but he's getting into the Alma backfield regularly already.
Well, they're going to give Henley a yard. It'll be second and 9. Ball is marked on the 40. Fast-moving first quarter, minus all of the penalties. Kevin Taylor here from the Times Record covering this game. Winner of this ball game will play the winner of Little Rock Christian. Win next week. Whoever doesn't come out on top packs it in for the year. Landon on the keeper. Landon hit at the line of scrimmage. Carries the pile forward for about 5 yards. It'll be third down and 5, Alma. This is something the Airedales have to stay away from, guys. They are not a third down and long team. They've picked up some third down and longs, but more often than not, they have not been able to pick those up. If you get them into a passing game, that's not their strength this year. Their strength this year is running the football and power football. You know, 3-4 yards in a cloud of dust, and who cares, man, as long as you score and as long as you win. I could care less if they ever throw a pass. So here we go, third down and 5 from the Airedale 44. Landon, shotgun, everyone tucked in tight. Overload to the left. He's running left. Landon will be very close to a first down. I think he picked up the first down from the spot of the official. I think he picked it up. It's going to be awful close, and they are calling for the first down. They'll move the chains. Nice run for Landon Blair. He needed 5 yards. He got 5 yards and 2 inches.
And that's one thing that at the last second, Whitehall made a substitution, pulled a linebacker out, and brought another lineman in and had a 5-man front on that. Still was unable to stop them.
Karsten Bonneau checks in. Bring
Winfrey out. Davis will be in. Grayson Bailey wide to the right side for the Airedales. They'll break the huddle at the 10-second mark on the play clock, and here we go. Grayson Bailey, the lone wideout on the far side. They overload to the right. Now they will run the Wildcat with Josh Davis. There's the snap. Davis will keep it to the right. Landon's lead blocker, midfield, 45-40. Still on his feet, all the way down to the 35-yard line is Josh Davis. A nice carry by Josh Davis. Give him 16 on the carry. First and 10 out as they mark it right down to the 36-yard line. Besides that, he gets a full head of steam going. He'll take on two or three.
Yeah.
Checking into the ball game, Nathan Whalen. Whalen comes in. Bailey will go wide to the left side on the first and 10 from the Bulldog 36. This drive started at the Airedale 25 after a Bulldog punt. Bobby Winfrey wide to the right side. Everyone else tucked in. Landon, he'll keep it, running left. Landon inside the 35, hit. Landon pushes forward to about the 32-yard line. Carry. 4 yards on the carry, second down and 6 yards.
Yeah, he ran right into Chris Fitzgerald again, and Chris is a little bit taller, but he doesn't have the sizes on Landon, and Landon carried him for about 2 yards.
Matt Cox comes in along with Matt Hamblin for the Airedales. Second down at 6 from the 32 of Whitehall. Wildcat form. Nope, they're going to put Landon under center. Davis is the back in the backfield just to the right of Landon. The overload is to the right. They pitch to Davis. Davis cuts it inside. Hit at the 31. Falls forward to about the 30. So 2 yards on the carry. Bring up the third down and 4 now for Alma. Clock is running. 2:45 left to play in the opening quarter. No score in our ball game. Finally, technical difficulties in the Gremlins worked out of the system, I think. I don't want to speak too soon.
No. What I like the way they designed that play is they've got Josh Davis back about 5 yards, and Landon just pitches it straight to him because then he gets out there and is a blocker.
Winfrey wide to the right side. Grayson Bailey wide to the left on third down and 4. Landon's going to keep it. Landon pushes forward. Landon will have the first down as he's moved it inside the 25. And it'll be first and 10 Alma at the 25-yard line of Whitehall.
Yeah, I mean, a big guy had him. Antonio Johnson had hard on him and was trying to bring him down. And then Seth Cole came in and helped move it, the extra yardage.
Coming in late, Jacob Corsi, he'll be the wide out to the left side. They have Bailey wide to the right. First down at 10 from the 25. They're going to keep it. No, that's Bailey in the backfield. Bailey's going to keep it inside the 20, inside the 15. Grayson Bailey, it looks like he was the wide out on the right side, but that was Bobby Winfrey. And they shifted and put Bailey as the quarterback. And Grayson carries it for another first down. It's first and 10 from the 9. It's a huge play for him. We've not seen that wrinkle in their offense this year.
And I'm sure he can probably throw the ball if he needed to.
I think that kid could throw it and then run down the field and catch it. Bono checks in. They will split Bailey wide to the right side on first and goal from the Bulldog 9. Davis in the backfield to the left of Landon Blair, the quarterback. Shotgun formation. Now they move and shift to the right. Davis will take the direct snap in the Wildcat. Davis is going to carry it to the right, following Landon, inside the 10, inside the 5, stood up at the 5. I think he picked up about 4 yards. It'll be second down and goal from the Whitehall 5-yard line. Clock at a minute 15 and continuing to run. As Alma will be looking at a second and goal on their opening drive at the Bulldog 5.
Yeah, they're definitely trying to keep Whitehall off balance because they're doing a lot of subbing.
A lot of shifting, too, with the quarterback moving over and letting Davis take the snap on the Wildcat. Alma will break the huddle with 10 seconds left. Davis will move to the right of Landon. Blair in shotgun formation, gets the snap, landing on the keeper, landing in the backfield, barely gets back to the 5-yard line, and man, they're still going at it again. And you know what? He'll end up getting flagged for a little before the 9-2. Well, that's number 51. I don't even have his name. Tristan Evett. When you put a player on the ground, that's fine. But to stand over him and taunt him, the officials hadn't put up with that too much this year. That's going to bring to a close the end of the first quarter. No score in our ball game as Alma and Whitehall, the Bulldogs. Second round action from Airedale Stadium. We'll be back with more right after this.
For over 70 years, we at the Venture Cooperatives of Arkansas have had our fan base. Our passion for delivering reliable, affordable power to every corner of Arkansas.
At the end of the first quarter,
17 electric district.
Airedale overtime with the Bulldogs 0-0.
That's power to more than half a million homes, farms, businesses, winter, spring, summer, and cool fall football Friday nights. The Electric Cooperatives of Arkansas, powering the thrill of Friday night nights.
Arkansas is known for its beauty. Rolling hills, scenic fields and valleys, and beautiful rivers run through our state. We want to keep Arkansas beautiful, but we need your help. Do your part by not littering and by keeping your community clean. Register for a local cleanup or become a litter grabber to fight litter at your own pace. Your community needs you. Join us in keeping Arkansas beautiful. Visit keeparkansasbeautiful.com to learn more. This message brought to you by the station, the Arkansas Broadcasters Association, and the Arkansas Beautiful Commission.
First quarter, no score in our ball game so far. Along with the football resting at the 5 of Whitehall, it will be third down and goal from the 5 as we get underway here in the second quarter. Airedales will send Grayson Bailey. He'll be lined up in the backfield under centers, Landon Blair. Well, they run this last week, but they had Winfrey. Mark Henley back, and they're pushing. They're going to pitch to Grayson. Grayson going to throw the football into the end zone, and it's intercepted. Wait a minute. How was the wide receiver shoved down and no penalty flag thrown? I do not get that. Winfrey was knocked to the ground, and then the defensive back made the catch. Or maybe Winfrey just got his feet tangled up. Guys, I couldn't see that well.
He got shoved to the ground.
So, I think, you know what? I don't see the coaches real animated on the sidelines. So the turnover.
No, they were out there. They were out on the field.
The turnover goes against the Airedales, and Alma will give it up to the Bulldogs. They'll have the ball first down and 10 from their own 20. Still no score in our ball game. Martinez gets the snap, hands off to Buckner. Buckner hit immediately at the line of scrimmage. He's going to have a long night. He will be bruised. Hope they have some ice bags for the ride home, no matter how this game comes out. And one thing I'll tell you, the Airedale defense will hit this guy. They'll hit him in the they'll hit him in the ribs, they'll hit him in the thighs, they'll hit him in the hips. They will absolutely put the lumber on him, you know, just to make sure that he knows that he's been in a ball game tonight. Here we go, second down and 10 from the 20. Martinez, they move Buckner to the right side. That's the empty side of the field. Trips to the left side. They change the play now. 13 on the play clock. Martinez, the sophomore quarterback, gets a snap, looking to pass. They throw it. Hello, Jacob Corsi.
He almost intercepted that.
Well, you know what? If he'd have been looking instead of looking at the defender or at the wide out, right, I think he could have picked it up. Mm. But he absolutely leveled the wide out. I think that was number 10, Caleb Taylor.
Yeah.
Taylor's over there. He's like, hey, don't call that play again. Do that not throw it my way
that
again.
That did not fool anybody.
No.
He saw him step back.
He knew. Yeah. Jacob Corsi, that's the biggest hit of the ballgame so far. Third down and 10 from the 20 for the Bulldogs. Martinez gets a snap. They were moving forward before the snap. Martinez is going to run the thing and hit it. Well, he throws the ball, and it's caught at the 32-yard line. I think that was for Stephen Weston on the reception. The running back that was in the backfield with him took off. Took a step and a half before the ball was snapped. He was moving forward. So I thought actually the play was going to be whistled dead.
Quarterback is limping.
Yeah, he was nicked up last week, guys. I hope he's all right because I want to see the full. Oh no, he's having to come out of the game. I was hoping that he'd be all right because, you know, you want to see him in full strength. You don't want
right.
to you don't want to beat him with a wounded player, and you never want to see that. So Caleb Taylor, number 10, sophomore, he'll come in and replace the sophomore Matthew Martinez, a quarterback. Buckner, I bet you're going to get a big old spoonful of him on first down and 10 from their 33. Buckner gets the call. Buckner hit the backfield. Buckner can't get free. Buckner will pick up about, oh, they're not even going to give him half a yard. He barely got back to the line of scrimmage.
Hey, the Alma defense, they've got it figured out. I've watched them. They had a pulling guard earlier. Matt Hamlin got right in behind him. They're understanding what they're supposed to be doing and executing it so far.
Second down and 10, clock running, 10:23 left to play until halftime. No score in our ball game. Alma's had it one possession. This is the second possession for the Bulldogs. They intercepted the Airedales in the end zone. Alma jumped off sides, and it was on the Airedales. They're the ones that moved. They were across the line of scrimmage before the ball was snapped. Now they're going to have to listen to this new quarterback.
Was it
the offensive move?
Yeah.
All right. Well, you know, all I could see was the Airedale.
The guard was over the snap. False start on the offense. 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
That off 5 yards. My bad. Sorry, Mr. Official.
Well, they didn't move a lot, but they about three of them twitched at the same time.
Well, that's the reason Alma jumped, I guess. So second down and 15 from the 28-yard line. Martinez back in. On second and 15, Martinez back to pass, looking. Here comes a rush. They throw it out in the flat, incomplete, but no gain on the play. And matter of fact, he's going to lose about 3 yards. A lot of extra hitting going on out there. Wow, Gabe Jensen.
Well, what I like about how they're using Gabe today is that we haven't seen. They'll bring in Logan Hollister, and Gabe will move up to defensive end.
Well, look at this. How did they spot the ball back at the 28? He caught it at the 25 and never moved forward. Never fell forward. They marked it at the 28. They're giving him no gain on the play. I don't get that. Third down and 15. Here we go. Martinez shotgun has Buckner to his left. Back to pass. Here comes a rush. Rushed out of the pocket. He's going to be hit as he throws, and it's out of bounds, and it's incomplete, and it's fourth down, and now the Airedales again have held, and they will force the Bulldogs to punt, and Martinez is, he got up slow, but yeah. Was that Jensen again?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, so they will drop Grayson Bailey back deep to receive. Kessler Purdue got off a great punt the last time. Jensen standing back on his 45. Punting from his own 15. Purdue gets it off a low line drive kick. And it's going away from Bailey. Bailey is going to pick it up. Bailey fumbles the ball and it's down. Holy smokes, are you kidding me? So Jason Bailey tried to pick it up. Ill advised on that. He fumbled the ball. One of the Bulldogs was on top of it. It squirted out as Alma kept after it. And finally, the Airedales came up with it. So, man, oh, man. Keystone Cops?
Yeah.
Is that Keystone Cops?
Wow.
Mike, you're too young to remember that. That was a group of cops. It was a black and white comedy back in the day. And, you know, they were clumsy, and they run all over the place. And so, first down and 10, Airedales, unbelievable, from their own 19 now. So Bailey was standing back on about his 35. The ball was kicked away from him. It was a low line drive kick by Purdue. And instead of having pretty decent field position, he got a good kickoff. And Alma chased it back and then fumbled. And then the Bulldogs fumbled and Alma finally tracked it down. 6 seconds on the play clock. Alma's going to either have to take a timeout or snap this thing. Yeah, they're not going to get it off. I didn't think they would. Alma took a timeout. They didn't lose the 5 yards. First timeout of the first half for the Airedales.
Before the snap, timeout. Alma.
52 left.
Their first timeout.
The first half, first down at 10. Alma on their own 19. Back with more from Airedale Stadium right after this.
What does an organic tissue donor look like? Like a person who's real cool, a true warrior. Like a hero who can save up to 8 lives with a single act of giving. Like a shining, mythical titan, bestowing beautiful, radiant light upon our Kansans in need. You know somebody who looks like that? You should, because we're talking about you, and you is where giving starts. Save 8, donate at DonateLifeArkansas.org. Give it.
Welcome back, everyone. 8:52 left to play here in the first half. No score in our ball game. Alma facing first down and 10 from their own 19-yard line. Second possession of the game for the Airedales. The last one, they started at their 25, drove all the way down to the Bulldog 5, and then threw an interception in the end zone. The Bulldogs were forced to punt for the second time tonight, so that's where we're at right now. Blair, shotgun formation, everyone tucked in tight for Landon. They move Bonneau in motion to the left side and overload the left side. Landon gets a snap. Landon reverses to come back to the right. He's at the 20, maybe the 22-yard line. A gain on the play of about 3, maybe 4 yards. They're going to mark it right around the 23, and it'll be second down and 6 out.
Man, this is for two teams that's probably never played that many games against each other. They are really chippy out there.
They're going at it. Corsi checks in along with Connor Stacy. Bonneau checks out along with Gunnar Summers. And also, who else comes out? Matt Cox. So they'll run Corsi and Stacy wide to the left side. I think that's where they're going to go. Bailey to the right side. Play clock's at 9. And here they are down again. The clock is running again. Alma's going to have to hurry up and get this one off. I don't know if they're going to get set. 3 seconds, 2 seconds. They get the snap off. They pit. Yep. Come on, man. You know, I don't know where the miscommunication's from, but they run two or three players in and two or three players out. It's taken a lot of time once they spot.
For the snap, false start on the offense. It's a 5-yard penalty. Remains second down.
Some of the players wasn't sure if they were supposed to come out. It just took a little time to get off the field. So 5-yard penalty on the Airedales, and it'll mark it back to the 18-yard line. And it'll be second down and 11. Winfrey goes wide to the left side. That's wide side of the field. You have the trips to the right side. That's Stacy, Corsi, and Grayson Bailey. Shotgun for Landon. Back to pass. Here comes the pressure. He throws it out. Complete to Bailey. He's at the 20, 25, 30. Grayson Bailey, 35, 40. Bailey, 45. Midfield. Finally brought down. Grayson Bailey. And a penalty flag comes flying in late at the midfield stripe. We'll wait and see what this is. Bailey. 32 yards.
They had Bobby Winfrey way out in front of him blocking him in. There was only two players down there, Winfrey and Bailey.
Let's wait and see what the call is. 32 yards on the catch and run.
Holding on the offense. So the penalty is 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Result of the play is a first down. Officials timeout for a helmet on Alma. Officials timeout.
What a nice, well-designed play. And what? You got to love the play calling and coach Greg Kendrick, the offensive coordinator. He has come in this year and just absolutely, once he got the kids on the same page after game 5, they have absolutely taken off. Got to visit with him a couple of weeks ago. Just a great guy. First and 10. Snap. There's Landon trying to carry it past the 40. He's going to be hit and stacked up at about the 42. Alma's already turned the football over twice. They threw one interception. They fumbled but managed to get it back. And guys, one of the keys to the game was hanging on to the football, taking care of it, and avoiding the silly penalties. Hey, our good friends at Alma Farm Supply sending the best wishes to the Airedales during this playoff run that they're making right now.
Jimmy, you talked about it earlier. You've been doing this a long time. How many second-round playoff home games have you had?
None. Well, no, not when we played on the road the first time. Second down and 8. The ball is at the 42 of Alma. Landon gets a shotgun. No, they snap it to Davis. Davis turns it upfield. And he's hit and stopped after about a 2-yard carry.
One thing about it, they're doing a great job of blocking out on the edges, but when this strings out too far, there's just too much speed on this Whitehall team for them to get anything going.
Third down and 6. They have to move it to the midfield stripe. It's just shy of the 44. Everyone tucked in tight. Landon shotgun on 3rd and 6. Landon, they pitch it to Grayson Bailey. He's at the 45, the midfield. He's off and running 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, and runs out of bounds at the 20-yard line. What a play by Grayson Bailey, and let's give a little credit to the downfield blocking by the Airedales as Connor Stacey got down there, made a couple of nice blocks, and also Mario Gonzalez and Braden Allen. Big play right there by Grayson Bailey, and a great call by Greg Kendrick, the OC. First down and 10 Airedales at the 19-yard line of Whitehall. Second time they've been in the red zone tonight. No score in our ball game. 5:52 left to play in the first half.
Yeah, that's one thing. Landon Blair does not have the arm to throw over the top of the defense, but you've got such a wonderful talent there, and they're learning to incorporate him in so many different ways.
Shotgun formation. Nope, Landon's under center. Blair pitches to Davis, left side, inside the 20, inside the 15, he's gone, touchdown, and 19-yard carry by Turner Davis on the left side. It's a great up-front block at the Alma Airedales. Man, you got to give a little credit to those guys because old Seth Cole's out there leading the way.
Made a key block on the outside.
5:44 left to play in the second. PAT coming up by Olaf Olsen. Good snap, good hold, kick is up. Right downtown, 5:44 left in the first half. Alma takes a 7-0 lead over Whitehall. You're listening to Airedale Football and Marshall, 96.7 FM.
7-0.
Buckner back deep to receive along with Cam Robinson for the Bulldogs. Airedales lead 7-0, 5:44 left to play in the first half. Olaf tees it up. High short kick's going to be fielded by Robinson at the 25 to the 30. Hit at the 30. He'll be brought down to 32-yard line. And you know, guys, we've been talking about the blocking of Landon Blair. Landon with the Alma team. They won the state powerlifter again. Landon, 500-pound squat.
God,
that guy's phenomenal. Carson Benoit, 400-pound squats, plus a 300-pound bench press.
Well, isn't Mr. Breeden, isn't he a volunteer?
Yeah, Larry Breeden. I've known Larry Breeden for forever and a day, man.
He looks like he could probably squat a truck.
Well, let me tell you something. You definitely want him on your side in an argument.
In a scrum.
Yeah, in a scrum. Martinez, shotgun formation, two wideouts, one on either side. Now they move Buckner to the left, back to pass. Martinez looking for the home run ball. It's going to be thrown short, and it's incomplete at midfield as the intended receiver, Cam Robinson. Yeah. Last time the Airedales were in the semifinals was 2013. That was that long trip to Batesville. That Batesville is where they have the stadium. The stands start at the midfield stripe and go to the left if you're on the home side. There are no stands on the other end.
Wow.
Thank you, Dr. McSpadden. I appreciate that update. Second down and 10 from the 32. Handoff. Buckner trying to bounce it outside. Buckner stopped in his tracks and he's hit. Listen, that kid's going to need some ice at halftime. Yeah. They are standing him up, and now a flag comes in late, but they're standing him up. And they're absolutely bringing two or three more to bring him down. He's strong, and he does not give up. He keeps running and fighting to get some yardage. But all that's going to do is bring a lot more pain.
I'm guessing that's going to be against Alma.
Yeah. After the play was over,
yeah.
Personal foul on the defense.
Yeah.
15-yard penalty from the end of the line.
Penalty, so they're
first down.
But what's happening is he's continuing to try to run, and he's not getting tackled, and they're not blowing the whistle, so they're continuing to hit him. Yeah, if they're blowing the whistle and they're hitting him after the whistle, that's one thing. But they just give him 15 yards. They move the ball all the way to the 44. I'm not making any excuses for the Airedales. You never want to see a personal foul like that. But you teach the kids to play till the whistle. So, and I'll give credit to the officials. We're not down there, so they may be blowing it. We may not be able to hear it up here. Here we go. First down and 10 from their own 44, Whitehall. Shotgun formation. They have two either side. They try to throw quickly. And here comes the blitz. And guess who? Grayson Bailey. Forced Martinez to try to duck under him. And he was going nowhere. And who finished him off? So is that? Oh, 52. Yeah, that's Hamlin. Matt Hamlin finished him off. A loss on the play of 3. It'll be second down and 13.
Well, I see why they don't throw a lot, because Matthew Martinez, a minute ago when he threw that one across field, that was everything he had.
Looked like one of your 9 irons. Kind of floating.
Mm-hmm.
Single wide out either side. Buckner in the backfield. Martinez, now they move Buckner to the right of Martinez. Buckner gets the handoff, trying it up the gut, has a little bit of running room, picks up about 3 yards. He gets back to the original line of scrimmage. It'll be third down and 10, maybe third down and less than 10. They are going to mark it just shy of the 45. Clock is running, 4:10 left to play in the first half. Alma leads 7-0 on the strength of a 19-yard touchdown run. Up the left side by Josh Davis on a 6-play, 81-yard drive by the Airedales in the second quarter. And here we go, big third down play. Hey, Coach Frankie Vines in the press box tonight. Good to see Coach here.
He's definitely regular.
Yes, he is. Martinez, shotgun formation. Two on the right, single on the left. Back to pass. Martinez has some time. They throw the screen. It's complete at the 41. And Buckner, you know what? He ran away from the tackle that time. He went down to the turf and was not going to get hit. You saw it from our vantage point. When he got wrapped up the first time, he just like, yeah, he's like, no, not again. Nope, not doing it. And short of the first down. It'll be fourth down and 6, and they'll be forced to punt for the third time in the first half, guys.
Yep, that Alma defense, we've seen them do it in the past, not as much this year, but they're coming to play, and they're hitting him, and he is feeling it.
Now, if you're Alma, you want to back up and stand back about the 20. You can always move forward. Purdue has got off a couple of really good kicks. Snap to the right, Purdue, plenty of time. Nice kick again. Fair catch call for it to 20. What did I say? Stand back where? There you go.
Spot on.
First down and 10, Alma from their own 20. 2:57 left to play in the first half. Airedales lead 7-0. Back with more right after this.
Pregnancies can find critical care for brand new beginnings. We are UAMS, and we're here for a better state of health.
First down and 10, Airedales. They pitch the ball out to the right side. That's Grayson Bailey. Gets it past the 20. Bailey tackled at about the 22-yard line. And it will be second down and 8 for the Airedales. Clock is running. 2:43 left to play in the first half. Alma still with 2 timeouts left. Whether they decide to take them or not, I think it'll depend a lot on this play, guys. If they pick up a good chunk of yards and get down close to midfield on a nice carry or a nice pass, I think you'll see them start using the clock. 2:38 and counting. Play clock's at 19. Airedales get to the line of scrimmage. Landon, shotgun formation. Tailback on either side. Blair gets the snap. Blair hands off left side. Grayson Bailey. Bailey to the 25 and carried forward about the 29-yard line. And it will be third down and 1 for Alma, as he was helped along by Nick Archer.
he grabbed him.
He just grabbed him and suplexed him. Monday Night Raw going on.
Yeah, and let him land on him.
Yep. Third down and 1. Landon, take the direct snap. He's going to keep it right up the middle. Landon has the first down as he carries it barely across the 30. And they'll stop the clock to move the chains. 1:46 left to play in the first half. Airedales lead 7-0. They scored on their second possession. This is the third possession of the first half for Alma. Pine Bluff's had it twice, or Whitehall's had it twice, or 3 times themselves. They've been forced to punt all 3 times. Clock is running now as they spot the chains, spot the ball on the 31. Empty backfield for Landon Blair, senior quarterback out of Alma. Back to pass, looking right all the way, throws, and it's tipped up in the air. Oh, but look at Winfrey. Bobby Winfrey stayed with it. The ball was tipped up by a lineman of Whitehall, and it still had enough on it to move forward. You know, Winfrey was the intended target the entire time. Never moved. Nope. And he picks up seven on the catch. Second down and three. Back to pass again. Here comes the blitz. Landon, screen. Grayson Bentley drops it. He had some running room, man. He had some running room with Nick Archer out there blocking for him. It'll stop the clock with 1:07 to play in the first half. It will be third down and three from the Airedale 38-yard line, and you could tell he had end zone on his mind.
He was looking upfield before he caught the ball.
Winfrey had his guy maintained. Damn, he had plenty of room to run.
Third down and three. I think they're just going to down it here. Landon, under center. Nope, they're going to go ahead and pitch it. That's Henley. Henley's going to carry it across the 40. I think he'll be short of the first down. I don't think he gets the first down. It's going to be awful close. They're going to give him the progress right to the 41, and it is a first down. 58 seconds left to play. Alma still with two timeouts now, guys. Yep.
At least a field goal.
Yeah. Let's see what Olaf can do if they need it. And look, Whitehall getting a player off late. He got off out of bounds in time. Back to pass. Landon looking. Here comes the pressure. Landon. He's going to throw. He's got a man in. Oh, it's almost intercepted. And Winfrey's going to catch it at the 34-yard line. The ball was tipped up in the air by Connor Stacy. It was almost intercepted, guys. Connor Stacy got a hand on it, tipped it up the air. In the air. Winfrey saw the ball coming down, dove for it, managed to keep his feet in bounds, made a sweet catch. Alma has the ball first and 10 on the 34-yard line of Whitehall with 37 seconds left. Oh, my.
That's right. Tip practice comes in.
Exactly right. Under center, Landon Blair. They have one wide out in the pattern on the left. They're going to run a reverse. Grayson Bailey, a little pitch back.
Oh, wide open.
He's got it wide open. Caught the three. Or the five. Touchdown, Connor Stacy. Wide open at the 10. And he was caught by number three, Connor Stacy. And Alma goes down and scores with 28 seconds left to play in the first half on the flea flicker.
Hey, that's what got him into the game last week, too.
Reverse flea flicker. So after a slow first quarter that was 0-0, the Airedales have put 13 with a PAT coming up. Good snap, good hold. Oh, kick is up, and the kick is good. 28 seconds left to play in the first half. Alma leads Whitehall 14-0. Back with more from Airedale Stadium right after this.
Saracen Casino Resort, building our community one student at a time.
Your first home is like this dream. The day you walk in, the sun seems to shine more brightly. The ceilings, they just seem taller. And you'll never fix that creaky floorboard because it sounds like comfort. What a hug would sound like if it made a sound. And that's when you realize you're home, really, really home. Realize your dream with a home loan from Simmons Bank. Dreams realized. SimmonsBank.com. Member FDIC, equal housing lender, subject to credit approval.
Double reverse flea flicker. 32-yard pass to Connor Stacy. 28 seconds left to play in the first half. Alma leads 14-0. Here's Olaf on the kick. A high, short kick. Fielded at the 30 with a fair catch. And Whitehall will have 28 seconds left to work here in the first half. And you got to think, after Martinez, their quarterback, was banged up a little bit, you got to think they're just going to take a knee and try to get back into halftime and regroup, guys, because right now they're shell-shocked. Alma just went 80 yards in seven plays.
And they're smacking them right in the mouth. I mean, they've come to play, and they're executing excellent.
Let me tell you something. I don't know if you said, like I have, but I've been watching them kids, and they are all pumped up on that Alma team.
Yeah, they are.
When they come in, they're high-fiving, they ain't letting nobody get what to do without it.
Yeah, they're going to. They're just going to take a knee. Yeah, you know what? I don't blame them. I do the same thing. They'll take a knee, and they'll run the clock out, and they'll go into halftime. And for those Airedale fans that are here in the stadium, we have some of them that are tuned us that have tuned us in on the radio down there. They've looked up and waved at us, so we certainly appreciate that. For all of you that are watching on the live stream or have us on the radio at home, we certainly appreciate that as well. And welcome to the Crabtree RV halftime show, where your family's dreams come true. Airedales lead Whitehall, second round of the state playoffs, a semifinal berth on the line tonight. They lead Whitehall 14-0 at the half.
Thank you, River Valley, for the fourth consecutive year. You voted Crabtree and Alma the best place to buy an RV. To show our appreciation, we are beginning our Christmas cash day sale early. From now through New Year's Eve, you can choose sales tax pay or $1,000 in Christmas cash on the purchase of any RV from Crabtree, and we'll still give you the most for your trade. The best happening now at Crabtree RV in Alma, where your family's dreams come true.
Right there again. Simply put, Bancorp South gives you the banking relationship you want.
At this time, we'd like to welcome to the field the Whitehall Bulldogs.
We'd love to have you. So for all your banking, business, mortgage, and insurance needs, call or visit your local branch or go to Bancorp. You are member FDIC, equal housing lender.
This is Mark Hurst. Late fall and early winter are my favorite times of the year. Football playoffs, time spent with my sons at deer camping in the duck blind, and the holiday season begins. November and December are also great times to take advantage of any remaining dental insurance benefits before the first of the year. Give us a call today at 474-1972 and let us help you maximize your remaining insurance benefits. Or if you don't have dental insurance, ask about our dental discount plan. Hurst Family Dental Care, a name you know and a name you can trust.
Alma Farm Supply says nothing is better for your wildlife than a food plot that provides nutrition 24/7, regardless of the weather or your schedule. You can start fall food plots now with a visit to Alma Farm Supply. Find a large seed mix with wheat, oats, rye, winter peas, and cowpeas, plus two small seed mixes, one a blend of four clovers, including fixation clover, and one with a blend of annual greens containing turnip, rapeseed, kale, and radishes. Seed blends from Whitetail Institute also available. Give your wildlife the nutrition they need with a food plot mix from Alma Farm Supply. 428 Highway 64 East in Alma. Call 632-3194. Alma Farm Supply.
Edwards Van Alma Funeral Home proudly supports local youth to area teams for a great year and a winning football season. A reminder to players that whether you're in the classroom or on the field, work hard, play hard. Be the best that you can be. Good luck to everyone from Edwards Van Alma Funeral Home, your local Dignity Memorial provider.
Welcome back to Halftime. It is the Crabtree RV Halftime Report, where your family's dreams come true. You know, guys, we talked about this, Ray, on the way to the stadium today. Mike, I had Mike on the phone with us. The Crabtree RV, largest indoor showroom in the region, not just locally, but in the region. If you're in the market, want to do some camping, just want to get away where you're not going to be bothered for a while, and you don't want to leave the comforts of home at home, you can go by Crabtree RV. They have all sizes to fit your needs. No matter if you have a family of 10, they have a camper that fits all your family. Yeah, if it's just you, they have a perfect camper just for you. If it's just you and you want a big camper that'll fit 10, no problem. They'll do that for you too. Whatever you need, I guarantee they'll take care of you. We're at halftime right now, where the Airedales lead 14-0. And this is how we got there. 5:44 left to play after no scoring in the first quarter. 5:44 left in the second quarter. Josh Davis on an impressive drive by the Airedales, a six-play, 81-yard drive. Davis carries it off the left side for 19 yards. The PAT by Olaf was good, and it was 7-0 Airedales. Then they force Whitehall to punt again, and they take the ball with 2:07 left to play in the first half. March the thing, 80 yards. In seven plays, and with 28 seconds left, a double reverse flea flicker, 32-yard pass from Landon Blair to Connor Stacy. The PAT by Olaf was good, and it's 14-0 Airedales. Now, I said this last week, and I want to reiterate it again. course, this game isn't over. Whitehall, a very talented team, they can come back and win this thing. But for those of you that doubted this team, doubted the heart of these young players on this field, look at you now. Second round of the playoffs, playing Whitehall, leading 14-0 at halftime.
At home.
Started 0-5 on the season. Everybody gave up. Well, not everybody. Miss Sharon and Miss Carolyn did not give up. Those two never give up. They live and breathe Airedale sports. Mike Hessen says he didn't give up. I know Ray didn't.
No.
The big deal was the kids didn't give up.
The kids didn't give up. And you know why? Listen, it's the coaching staff. It's Doug Lockridge. He's the head guy. Then you've got, you know, Greg Kendrick, the OC. Eric Morris, the defensive coordinator. Chris Smith. Josh Driscoll. Chad Powell. You know, Corey Sturdivant. Zach Jones. Dylan Work. These guys kept these kids focused and said, listen, guys, all you have to do is believe. Now, they posted something. They showed they had a breakfast over at Dee's Family Restaurant here in Alma for the kids on Friday morning. And they played a 13-minute video. And it had guys like Stockamer, all right?
Yeah.
It had Coach Vines. It had it had some other guys on there that were past Airedale players. It went on and on and on, and they let each one of them talk to these kids, you know, in the video. And they, you know, and so it was kind of a cool video. And if you can find it, it's on the Airedale Sports thing on Facebook. If you can find it, it's a good watch. And it'll just teach you, don't give up. They haven't given up. You know, I made a post on Facebook after last week's game talking about, you know, small town America and how, you know, when other towns, and we've all seen it, when other kids and other towns have opened up a season 0-5, they've just mailed it in. Some of the kids, they quit the team.
Oh.
The ones that were left, they just mailed it in. You know, they just kind of halfway play. And just to get through the season, they were done. This Airedale team, they went back and buckled down and worked even harder. You know, and Coach Lockridge shared with me, he said, you know, after that 0-5 start, he called me that Wednesday night. He said, you know what? And Monday and Tuesday's workout and today's workout, probably the hardest we've had all year. He said, and it wasn't the coaches pushing them. He said, these guys were just out there just giving it more than they have all year long. And he said, you know what? They're mad. They're not mad at the fans for giving up on them. They're mad at themselves for not playing better. Look where we're at now.
Yeah. And a big key is after that, Nick Archer came back after that. And
yes.
I think, you know, senior leadership, some people say it doesn't matter. I think that had a big key into it.
Yeah.
That it really changed the focus of the kids.
I think so, too. You're listening to the Crabtree RV Halftime Report, where your family's dreams come true. We will. We have an update. Greenwood and Salem Springs are tied in the first half. We'll try to bring you some scores that are in the playoffs and bring you up to date on some scores. We're at halftime, where Alma leads Pine Bluff Whitehall 14-0. Second round of the state playoffs. Semifinal matchup next week is on the line for the winner of this game. So let's take another quick timeout. We'll come back with some scores right after this.
Are you looking for a way to raise the profile of your business? Call Tori at Tori's Sign Shop. Tori can wrap your logo on any vehicle, large or small. Tori can make banners, lighted signs, metal signs, color flash signs, and much more. Get your business the attention it deserves. Call Tori's Sign Shop today at 479-632-2281. For super fast delivery, it's Tori's Sign Shop, 2 miles west of Alma on Highway 64. Email your job to torissignshop@hotmail.com.
Accidents are never fun. Don't take your vehicle to just anyone. The professional team at Autoplex is committed to quality first and your complete satisfaction. Our ASE certified technicians will repair your vehicle to pre-accident condition efficiently and quickly with a warranty on all repairs. On-site insurance filing and rental cars available. At Autoplex, we look forward to making your experience with us easy in our state-of-the-art facility. Autoplex Collision Repair. Quality first, always.
Of our neighbors and the respect of our peers. It's what the Ocker
Funeral Home family has done for the last 100 years. Five generations of caring, and those traditions truly make a difference with a more affordable price and superior service. You know you can depend on our family to serve your family. The Ocker family of funeral homes in Van Buren, Alma, and Fort Smith.
Simon Family Dentistry proudly supports Alma Airedale's athletics. Look to Dr. Jeremy Simon at Simon Family Dentistry. From tooth-colored fillings, braces, to root canal therapy, to dentures, bridges, and crowns, a visit to Simon Family Dentistry will have you flashing your brightest smile ever. Dr. Jeremy Simon and his caring staff welcome you to Simon Family Dentistry, 191 Highway 64 East in Alma. Open Monday through Thursday from 8 till 5. Behind the Airedales all the way, Simon Family Dentistry, 430-7049.
Don't put your health last. Pointer Trail Family Medical Clinic at 109 Pointer Trail in Van Buren. Dr. Carolyn Dillard and nurse practitioner Danielle Weaver are ready to help you and your family get well and stay well through routine medical checkups. Colds, flus, allergies, or if you're ready to drop that weight, they can help you at Pointer Trail Family Clinic. They take walk-ins and appointments. Call 479-922-2222 to make an appointment today. Pointer Trail Family Clinic, helping put you and your health first.
Still about 10 minutes until second half gets underway here at Alma. Now, Alma will have the football to start the third quarter, guys, yep. As Whitehall won the coin toss. They elected to take the ball first. So far, this Whitehall offense has been highly ineffective, and it's simply because of the upfront blocking and pushback of the Alma defensive line and guys like Karsten Bonneau and Gabe Jensen and the whole host of them that are getting in the backfield and breaking up Matthew Martinez, the quarterback.
Yeah. Like you said, Jensen, he's been on the field a lot.
How about Connor Stacey that hit him? Oh, my goodness.
He shut the gag. He shut the gap on that.
They run a three wide set, and when Caleb Taylor took a step back to get the pass, Stacy just, I mean, he was right on him, and he hit him the minute the ball got him. He timed it perfectly.
You know, so what are you talking about? I mean, he didn't look at one for 3 minutes. He's watching him warm-ups. He didn't have a good release. He's got to wind it up.
Wind it up, yeah. Yeah.
That kind of hurts him.
Well, because Alma's in the backfield all night.
Yeah, guy doesn't have time. Mm-hmm. Well, you know, we've been looking on Fearless Friday, and I don't want to bust anybody's bubble, but also, Larry, where were you checking at? Was that Max Preps? Max Preps has the score at halftime, 35-7. Ray, you got a report that it was 7-all. Was that at halftime?
He just texted us 7-7.
Yeah, and on
defensive back, Jonathan. Started the defense for the Airedales with a sack of Bulldogs. Number 13, Matthew Martinez. This forced Bulldogs to punt with number 9, Grayson, receiving the ball on their own 35. The Airedales got caught on a 3rd and 6, but number 23, Josh Davis, received the ball for the first down. Alma got blood with a 15-yard touchdown by Josh Davis. The first half ended with your score of your Alma Airedales number 3, Connor Stacey, and a second successful PA by Olaf Olsen, number 6, PA. The kicker for the Airedales. Be sure to stay tuned as the part of Alma performs and catch the after-game report by Jonathan Morgan. For Always Media, this is Terry Lewis.
Absolutely.
drivers once again, the 2019 5A state runner-up Alma dance team. Now, welcome to the field, the pride of Alma.
Gentlemen, for your halftime enjoyment, please welcome to the field the Alma High School Marching Band. Tonight, we present for you Seven Nations Army by the White Stripes, the Hey Song by Gary Glitter, and your Alma High School fight song.
Tickets for project graduation. Hold those now. We're on the way, but I'm excited. 50-50, Larry. And your 50-50 tickets for project graduation.
50-50 winner is ticket number 032864. That's 032864. To the winner of tonight's 50-50 prize, you can claim your prize at the project graduation booth underneath the home stands. Again, 032864.
Thank you.
Personal foul, illegal blindside block against the offense, 15-yard penalty from the spot of the foul, still first down.
Second down and long. Yeah, they're going to mark it on the 31.
Yeah, the safety.
He blew that up.
Irwin Williams came up and made an incredible tackle, but they're getting pressure on him already in the backfield, which they never did in the first half.
Corsi and Stacy go wide to the left side. You have Winfrey and Bailey wide to the right side on second and 21. Davis in the backfield, back to pass, rolling, looking, throwing, got a man, and he overthrows. He throws it behind Grayson Bailey at midfield. Bailey was running to the outside, and the pass was to the inside. He had to turn around and try to catch it over his shoulder. It's incomplete. It's third down at 21, so a huge penalty has really forced the Airedales into a bad situation on third down at 21 from their own 41. We're tied at 14 in the third quarter, 10:15 to play. Clock is stopped after the incomplete pass. And here we go. Two wideouts to the right. That's a wide side of the field. They send a wideout to the left. That's Winfrey on the far left. On third and 21, back to pass. Plenty of time. He's looking, throwing, got a man. That's Winfrey in the 45. Winfrey knocked out of bounds about the 49-yard line. They're going to mark him out right at the 49. And it will be a fourth down and 14, and this is the first punt of the night for the Airedales.
Yeah, I think Whitehall decided they're not ready for their season to end and came out with a little spirit.
What are you doing? Cold out there. I guess Max Preps listens to us because they changed the score. They had a 35-7 Greenwood at the half. That's probably wishful thinking on their part. Landon? Back to punt. Landon running to the right. soccer-style kick, high kick, going to hit at the 25, taking Alma bounce inside the 20, down to the 17, and that's where Whitehall will have the football for their first possession of the third quarter. First down and 10 on their own 17. 9:55 to play in the third. Airedale's lead 14-0. Back with more on the Marshall right after this.
Buying a new home can be stressful. Packing, paperwork, more packing. With all that goes along with making the big move, I'm so glad that I have Citizens Bank to guide me through the mortgage loan process. Their rates are competitive, and that's important. But the friendly, knowledgeable lenders taking the guesswork out of home loans for Citizens That means a lot, because I have more packing to do. Citizens Bank and Trust. That's my bank.
Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Martinez on first and 10, hands off to Buckner, right side. Bonneau's after him. He gets away from Bonneau into the secondary, past the 25, out to about the 29-yard line. First down and 10. So, you know, this is similar to what Whitehall did in the first half. They had a really good carry, and then all of a sudden, they were stuffed a couple of times and went to the passing offense, and Alma shut that down with a lot of pressure on the quarterback, the sophomore Matthew Martinez. We'll have to wait and see what happens here on this play. Alma brought the pressure. Bonneau just could not get to the ball carrier Buckner, so the wide side is to the left side on first and 10 for the 29. Whitehall with the football. They trail 14-7. Play action. Back to pass. Martinez. He's got a guy wide open. Nobody's back there.
Oh, boy.
And if he outruns him, this is a touchdown, Whitehall. And
he's
it is.
He's going to outrun him.
He outrun him. Alma fell asleep at the wheel in the defensive secondary. And a 71-yard touchdown pass brings Whitehall to a touchdown and a PAT from tying this thing up. I told you Whitehall would not give up. They'd come out and they'd play hard in the second half. And Alma fell asleep in the defensive secondary. That was number 15. Wasn't that Austin Shore?
18.
And number 18, Griffin Johnson?
Yeah.
He was wide. Listen, there was nobody 20 yards around him.
No, they bought on the play action big time.
PAT. Number 22, Barnes. Good snap, good hold. The kick is up, and it's good. 9:15 to play in the third. We got a ball game. It's 14-7. Alma back with more from Airedale Stadium right after this.
Need some holiday spending? Stop into Meadows Lumber, True Value, and stock up on Holiday Wonderland LED light rooms. They're just $14.99 each after a $1 instant rebate for True Value Rewards members. Choose from 200-count mini lights, 200-count C3 lights, or 75-count faceted C9 lights. Each style is 50 feet long and available in cool white, warm white, or multicolor. And it's free for all. Get this bargain of the night now while supplies last at Meadows Lumber, True Value.
71-yard touchdown pass. Martinez to Griffin Johnson, senior wideout. Just like that, it's 14-7. Still Airedales with the lead. Davis, Bailey back deep to receive. You got to bet they're not going to kick it to either one of those guys. This is just strategy football now. They have a hole right in the middle between Levi Burkhart and Braden Allen that they're just tempting the kicker Barnes to put it through. Barnes tees it up. Barnes, just a high short kick. It's going to be fielded by Bailey at the 25 to the 30. Ooh. Hit and thrown down at the 30. Grayson Bailey after a 5-yard return. And right now, the swagger's been taken out of the Alma Airedales.
Yeah, Marcus Taylor came in and made a fantastic tackle on that play. And as you said, they're playing with a little bit more pep in their step after coming out after halftime.
First down and 10 Airedales. The ball is at their own 30 as they start the second drive of the third quarter for Alma. Landon Blair, everyone tucked in tight. Need to stay away from the penalties. Blair is going to keep it on the right side. 30, Blair, 35. Blair still on his feet. Landon to the 40. There's that 500-pound squat. He just kept running and running over Bulldogs, and he picked up 10 yards, first and 10 Alma.
Yeah, he's not going to beat anybody in the 10-yard dash. But as you said, just his strength can carry him places that speed doesn't really have to be there.
Well, they have it listed at 6'1", but you go stand next to him, he's taller than 6'1".
Mm-hmm.
They have him listed at 240. You go stand next to him. Just his shoulders across are more than 240. This guy's a gentle giant.
Mm-hmm.
Under center. Everyone tucked in tight for the Airedales. First and 10 on their own 40. The pitch is back to Henley. Henley trying the left side. Henley across the 40 to the 45-yard line to the 46. Yes, I did. Davis checks in now for Alma. Henley carries for six. Second down and four, Alma. This is Alma football now. And look who's getting up limping, and I don't blame him, man, after that hit. That's Kyrene Rogers, the senior defensive back. He's like, man, those guys hurt. They hit hard, man.
I couldn't figure out who it was. It was Matt Cox that pancaked him there.
Yes, he did. He said, I'll take a little syrup and butter on that pancake I just put on you.
Mm-hmm.
Second down at four. Airedales, the ball is at their own 46-yard line. 7:50 to play in the third. They lead 14-7 under center. Landon pitches back to Davis. 45. Davis to the 48-yard line and hit and pushed back. It'll be third down and two at Alma. The clock continues to run. Under 7.5 now left in the third.
I was guessing number 29 is a senior, and he is. He's come out to play, and it's like, hey, I've got to leave it out here on the field because we lose this, I'm done. My career's over. And now he is just flying around the football.
Third down and three from the Airedale 49. They have to move it to the 49 of Whitehall. They'll let the play clock work its way down to 10. They break the huddle, and here come the Airedales. Everyone with Henley behind Landon Blair. They know what's coming. Blair keeps it, goes on the right side. Blair pushes across the midfield stride. First down and 10, Alma. Would you expect anything else?
No.
That's a freight train right there, my friends. With Landon Blair as the engine, and the caboose is Ben Henley. And Henley just helped his friend Landon pick up that first down. They picked up 3 yards on the carry. The ball is spotted at the 48. Of Whitehall, even though Whitehall had 11 in the box.
Yes, they did.
They couldn't stop it.
They didn't even have one back.
They could have went 3 wide and still not been able to stop it. And knowing where Alma was going with the ball. First and 10, Airedales. Landon shotgun. Landon's going to keep it. Try the left side. Landon going to be hit and stopped at the 45. Falls forward to the 40. A gain on the play of 4 yards. Second down and 6, Alma.
Yeah, that's where the Alma offensive line, they're just owning it tonight, because that right there, you get 3.5 to 4 yards every single play. You're not going to have to throw it or anything else.
Seth Cole working hard on that offensive line tonight. Nick Archer, all of those guys.
Sam Davila,
Logan Ingram. They're all in there playing. Sam Davila, man. What a good young man he is.
Mm-hmm.
Second down at 6, Alma. Play clock's at 3. Landon gets a snap. Landon hit in the backfield.
Ooh,
and is going to be thrown for a 2-yard loss. They shot the gap that time and got into the backfield. That's the first time we've seen the Bulldogs be able to get to Landon before he could get to the line of scrimmage. Big play here for the Airedales.
Yep, they'll stand around and count down to about 13 or 14 seconds and then start lining up.
Absolutely right. Third down and 8. Shotgun formation for Alma. Now they shift. They'll run the Wildcat with Davis. Davis gets the call. Davis trying the right side. They're stringing it out. Mm-hmm. Alma, they turn the corner. Davis hit
almost
at the 42-yard line. He will gain about 4 yards. It'll be fourth down, and we're going to call it 4. This will be an interesting call here for the Alma coaching staff. Fourth and 4 from the 42 of Whitehall. Alma leads 14-7. 4:30 left to play in the third quarter. Grayson Bailey, the Airedale's going to go for this thing, guys. I kind of had a feeling they were going to. They want to keep this momentum. Grayson Bailey goes wide to the left side. Landon Blair will get the snap. Landon. You know what? They're going to change the play. 10 seconds on the play clock. Now they move Davis to the right side. They overload the right. Landon gets a snap. Landon's going to keep it. Landon tries to bounce outside. He's not going to pick it up. They're going to hold Landon Blair, and they continue to push, but now they're whistling it dead. They're going to hold him at the 41-yard line, and that's where Whitehall will take over on downs. Now, different Whitehall team than what we saw in the first half. They took the wind out of their sails, and since then, Whitehall has regrouped, and they come back out. Alma needs to make some adjustments on the fly now. Because they've had the ball twice, and they've not moved it very effectively.
Yep, I'm thinking number 56, Antonio Johnson, he's playing defensive tackle and guard. And I'm kind of thinking he's wanting maybe a little water break.
Yep.
He's a big boy out there.
Martinez with Buckner in the backfield. Two wideouts to the left. They move Buckner to the right. They overload. They hand off to the wideout who came in motion.
40, oh, he's got 45. The edge.
He's got the edge across the midfield stripe. And he picks up 13 yards.
There's They'll another flag. Chains.
Yep. Another late flag comes flying in on the far side. We'll have to wait and see what this call is.
It's right at the tackle.
Personal foul, face mask.
Face
on the defense.
Mask on the Airedale.
15-yard penalty from the end of the run.
The penalties here on these two drives have just, you know, when Alma had the football to start the third quarter, the penalty killed their drive, and now they've just given a gift to the Bulldogs of Whitehall. It's first down and 10, Whitehall at the Airedale 31. Best drive of the night, other than that long pass play of 71 yards Whitehall's had. Buckner gets the call, trying the left side. Airedale string it out. He turns it upfield, hit it to 30, and maybe a half a yard on the game. I think my buddy Ronnie Winberg out of Adamina's got us tuned in. Lives in Fort Smith now. They call him the Geek. you remember Jimmy the Greek? Well, they call him Ronnie the Geek. And I like cracking on. Let me tell you something. Played ball against that guy in high school. Mm. You talk about a competitor. Good guy, man. It works out at Gridal. Just a great guy, man. Good family. A good dude. He's got us tuned in tonight. We certainly appreciate that. Second down and 9 from the Airedale 30. 3:03 left to play in the third. It's 14-7 Alma. Whitehall with the football on the move. Martinez wants to throw. Martinez throws. Completed to 25. Mm. Inside the 20 to the 15. That was a quick out, a quick hitter. Was that number 4? Yeah, that was. That was Stephen Weston. And they move the chains again. Guys, this is a totally different Whitehall team than what we saw in the first half.
Yeah, the quarterback does not have a strong arm to throw it a long distance, but he does have a nice arm to hit that little out pattern right there.
Ball is marked on the Airedale 14. First down at 10. Martinez, they move Buckner to the left. Buckner carries it to the right.
He's got the edge.
Buckner inside the 10. Buckner still on his feet. Down to the Airedale 7-yard line. This is a totally different Airedale defense, too. Now, what they've done is Whitehall has moved a couple of blockers that are pulling. And any time Buckner goes on the misdirection, they're pulling to that side. And Buckner's just following him until he sees a crease, and he's just diving in between the crease and picking up some more yardage. That was a gain of 7 yards. It'll be second down and 3 from the Airedale 7-yard line. They have to move it to the 4 for the first down. They send one wide out, far side to the left.
They've got Buckner.
That's Johnson. Buckner's the quarterback. He'll take the direct snap on the Wildcat. He carries it inside the 5. It'll be first down and goal, Whitehall on the Airedale 1.
Yeah, they definitely made some adjustments at halftime and coming out. Well, like Buckner, we watched him almost run out of bounds rather than get hit, and he's not doing that now.
Right. First and goal from the air. They're going to mark it about the 2. Buckner will take the direct snap again. Wildcat package, and he's in for the touchdown. They're an extra point from tying this game up, guys.
Mm-hmm.
Still waiting on the call. They finally put it on the board. Minute 31 left to play in the third quarter. We got a ball game. We knew it wouldn't be easy.
Oh, no.
PAT coming up from number 22, Kyler Barnes, sophomore kicker out of Whitehall.
Well, this team here, they've played the likes of Little Rock Christian, Maumelle, and Pulaski Academy. They know what they're doing.
Yep. Good snap, good hold. Kick is up. And the kick is good. We're tied. Minute 31 left to play in the third. We got a new ball game. We're tied at 14. You're listening to Airedale Football on the Marshall 96.7 FM.
Thank you, River Bond, for the fourth consecutive year. You voted Crabtree and Alma the best place to buy an RV. To show our appreciation, we are beginning our Christmas Cash Day sale early. From now through New Year's Eve, you can choose sales tax paid for $1,000 in Christmas cash on the purchase of any RV from Crabtree. And we'll still give you the most for your trade. The best deals of the year are happening now at Crabtree RV in Alma, where your family's dreams come true.
Third quarter, minute 31 left to play. Tied at 14 here in Alma tonight. Second round of the state playoffs between the Bulldogs of Pine Bluff Whitehall. The Alma Airedales, Whitehall with 14 unanswered points here in the third quarter to tie this thing up. The Airedales led 14-0 at the end of the first half. All the scoring for Alma was in the second quarter, and all the scoring for the Bulldogs here in the third. There's a low line drive kick. It's going to be fumbled. Alma will cover it at the 20. And the Airedales will take over first and 10. Now, sustain a drive. Don't make any silly penalties.
Yep.
Block. Hit the holes and run like the wind.
There you
go. There's your key for success.
Mm-hmm.
That's easy.
Sustain a nice long drive.
Isn't it? Easy. Easier said than done, huh?
Yep. Now you're playing a team that's got a new
Look at Robinson. Yeah. Robinson's over there talking smack to Sam Davila. Now listen, Robinson is he's a junior wideout. He probably will go 150, 160, and Davila 271. I think Davila wins every time. Alma with the football across the 20 to about the 23-yard line. And in the backfield again, and now another penalty flag flies as Davila hits the turf. And I don't know if that was a flop or if that was Academy Award there. Yeah, I don't know. Listen, it'd take a lot more than to throw that kid down on the turf like that.
Yeah.
But it's
that's what they're trying to do.
Yeah, it's number. They're trying to get in Alma's head. It's Antonio Johnson, the senior defensive lineman. Now the penalty flag was thrown at the 22, and it was after the run. Alma carried the ball to the 23, and let's wait and see what this call is. If they call this offsetting penalties,
no,
they're just going to pick it up.
After the play was over, personal foul on the offense. Penalties half the distance to the goal line.
Mark this off. Second down. There it is. So, wow. After you get Antonio Johnson in the middle of the pile, absolutely just ripping it up, Davila hits the turf, and they call the personal foul on Alma. They mark the ball back to the Airedale 13.
Well, one young man that is definitely, he's getting in the backfield almost every time is the defensive end, number 51, Tristan Evett, is really creating some havoc in the backfield right now.
Second down, 17 for Alma. Landon, back to pass. Throws. It's going to, almost picked off. Man, oh, man, listen, if to Kalen Walker had just looked up and gone for the ball, was that Walker or was that, no, that was number 5, Jacob Eichelberger. If he had just gone for the ball, that would have been a pick 6.
Man.
And he hit Josh Davis. Davis had to go up in the air to try to catch the thing. He hit him in the air. Perfect timing on the tackle. They knocked the ball loose. It's third down and 17.
And as we know, following Alma all year, this is definitely not their strength.
No. Third down at 17. They'll put trips to the right side, single wide out to the left. Davis in the backfield with Landon Blair on third and 17 from the Airedale 14. Back to pass. Looking, throwing. And it's almost picked off again. I don't know what that call was, but he threw it right to a Whitehall Bulldog, and luckily they didn't catch the thing, and it's fourth down. So the Airedales have touched the ball 3 times here in the third quarter. They've had 2 penalties that's killed 2 drives, and they turned it over on downs on the other one. Totally different Alma team than what we saw in the first half.
Yeah, the Whitehall coaching staff made some adjustments. got in the kid's head, and it's like the tale of two halves so far.
Cam Robinson back deep to receive the punt. Landon Blair standing back on his goal line with 50 seconds to play in the third to punt it away. Good snap. Low kick.
Boy.
It's going to be a short kick. Going to outbounce at the 34-yard line of Alma. Short field now for the Bulldogs. If you're the Airedales, your defense has got to come up and punch somebody in the mouth to get the football back. If you can do that, you'll get some momentum back for your team. If you're going to let them score and you go down 21-14, you know what? These kids are going to have to rally back again. We've seen them do it this year, but you surely don't want to have to lean on that time after time after time. So let's see what the Airedale defense and Coach Eric Marsh, the defensive coordinator, dial up. The ball was spot. They're going to spot this at the 37. It is first down at 10, Whitehall on the Airedale 37. 43 seconds left to play in the third. We're tied at 14. Here comes Martinez. They've not even sniffed him in the backfield. Every pass he's thrown has been quick, a quick hitter. He's not taking any time as Alma's put the pressure. Here we go. They move Buckner to the left. Buckner runs right up the middle. Buckner's going to be hit and tackled by Gabe Jensen. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Matter of fact, he barely got back to the line of scrimmage. Second down and 10, Alma. Yeah, there's two down. There's two Bulldogs down. And checking out of the ball game was Mario Gonzalez. He came over to get some attention from the trainers. We're going to take a quick timeout. 31 seconds left to play in the third quarter. We're tied at 14. You're listening to Airedale Football on the Marshall 96.7 FM.
At Bancorp South, we're right where you are. Literally. Want to bank online? We're there. Text banking? Yep. Banking app? Right there again. Simply put, Bancorp South gives you the banking relationship you want, so you can...
We cover the sports, the events, and the news.
Finding a way from the media room to the public.
Hard work and precision is what we strive to capture.
Capturing events in our community for all to see.
We are Airways Media.
Alma Farm Supply says nothing is better for your wildlife than a food plot that provides nutrition 24/7, regardless of the weather or your schedule. You can start fall food plots now with a visit to Alma Farm Supply. Find a large seed mix with wheat, oats, rye, winter peas, and cowpeas, plus two small seed mixes, one a blend of four clovers, including fixation clover, and one with a blend of annual greens containing turnip, rapeseed, kale, and radishes. Seed blends from Whitetail Institute also available. Give your wildlife the nutrition they need with a food plot mix from Alma Farm Supply. 428 Highway 64 East in Alma. Call 632-3194. Alma Farm Supply.
Edwards Van Alma Funeral Home proudly supports local youth athletic programs. They send best wishes to area teams for a great year and a winning football season. A reminder to players that whether you're in the classroom or on the field, work hard, play hard. Be the best that you can be. Good luck to everyone from Edwards Van Alma Funeral Home, your local Dignity Memorial provider.
Are you looking for a way to raise the profile of your business? Call Tori at Tori's Sign Shop. Tori can wrap your logo on any vehicle, large or small. Tori can make banners, lighted signs, metal signs, color plastic signs, and much more. Get your business the attention it deserves. Call Tori's Sign Shop today at 479-632-2281. For super fast delivery, it's Tori's Sign Shop, 2 miles west of Alma on Highway 64. Email your job to torissignshop@hotmail.com.
Accidents are never fun. Don't take your vehicle to just anyone. The professional team at Autoplex is committed to quality first and your complete satisfaction. Our ASE certified technicians will repair your vehicle to pre-accident condition efficiently and quickly with a warranty on all repairs, on-site insurance filing, and rental cars available. At Autoplex, we look forward to making your experience with us easy in our state-of-the-art facility. Autoplex Collision Repair. Quality first, always.
Welcome back, everyone. 31 seconds left to play in the third quarter. Play has been stopped. The injured Whitehall Bulldog, they're loading him onto a stretcher now. and we still do not have an official number on the young man, but during the play, when the play was over, he was still on the turf and grabbing his knee. We're certainly hoping that this young man's going to be all right. We will try to pass the name along to you as soon as we can find out. But the training staff from Alma, training staff from Whitehall, are out working on the young man.
26.
I can't tell.
I can't see. Is it 26? Yeah.
I'm not sure.
Tell.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, you know what? I bet it's 29. It's Aaron Williams.
Mm.
It's 29, Aaron Williams. Or at least that's who. And the Whitehall players are over there to pat him on the helmet as they take him over to the ambulance.
He's not 29 because I see him over there.
Okay,
so,
good. So here we go. It will be second down and 10. Sure, who it was. Second down at 10, Whitehall. Ball is on the Airedale 37. Martinez hands off to Buckner. Buckner trying to turn it outside. He has a blocker. He's hit at the 35. Breaks free inside the 30, inside the 25. It'll be first down at 10, Whitehall. As Buckner just was very patient on the corner. That's something he wasn't in the first half, guys. He wasn't patient at all. And he was trying to turn it up and pick up big yards right off the bat. This time he's following his blockers. And when they block to the inside, he'll bust it to the outside. If they block to the outside, he'll cut it back to the inside. And it's working right now.
Yeah, and it just shows you his speed, because Grayson Bailey came off of the edge and was able to and could not catch him.
He so
chased him the whole way.
14-14. That's the end of the third quarter. 12 minutes left in this football game. The winner moves on to the state semifinals. The other team packs it in for the winner and moves on to basketball. Final 12 minutes coming your way next on the Marshall.
Earning the trust of our neighbors and the respect of our peers. It's what the Ocker Funeral Home family has done for the last 100 years. Five generations of caring. And those traditions truly make a difference with a more affordable price and superior service. You know you can depend on our family to serve your family. The Ocker family of funeral homes in Van Buren, Alma, and Fort Smith.
First down and 10 from the Airedale 22-yard line. You know, the Airedales have been a bend but don't break defense this year. So we'll have to wait and see if the Airedale defense rises up to this occasion. Martinez, the quarterback. They move Buckner to his left. That's a wide side of the field. Buckner on the misdirection. Oh, Martinez is going to carry it right up the middle. Mm. He's inside the 20, inside the 15, down to about the 12. That's the first time he's run the football tonight, guys, by design. And it looks like it's a first down. I think they're going to measure.
First down.
It is a first down.
But with the success of Dante Buckner, the play action is really working on Alma right now.
First down at 10 from the Airedale 12. Martinez, shotgun formation, Buckner to his right. They overload to the right. They hand off, and a penalty flag flies. They hand it off to the wideout. He's in for the touchdown, but this thing is coming back as it was holding. Nope.
Illegal motion.
Illegal motion on Whitehall. That was one of those plays that they were called on two or three times in the first half where they're just moving before the ball was snapped and moving towards the line of scrimmage, and they finally whistled it here in the second half, first time they've been penalized in the second half.
Yeah, they've continually had number 37 moving back and forth, and then he when he gets set, he's a little bit too early on the movement.
They're going to mark the ball back to the 17. It will be first down and 15 from the Airedale 17. 11:23 left to play in the ball game. Tied at 14. Two wideouts to the left side. That is Weston and Robinson. Single wide out to the right side is Johnson. Buckner gets the call right up the gut. Buckner inside the 15, falls to about the 13-yard line. A gain on the play of 4 yards. Second down and 11. You know, the Airedales are going to hold them right here. You just feel it. The defense has not stopped them in the third quarter. You just kind of feel it. You can just kind of see them picking up on it and starting to pick up the pace.
Well, one thing about it, the offensive line for Whitehall is very big.
Oh, yeah.
And they're, I think they're trying to start leaning on them a little bit, but as you said, Alma always has that extra gear in the fourth quarter.
Second down and 11, Buckner to the left, play action, one to throw into the end zone. Alma breaks up the pass, and Joseph York got lucky on that one, guys. He never looked back,
turned around,
but he got his hands up. And the pass was thrown to York's right shoulder. The wideout, Cam Robinson, was to York's left shoulder. And he just couldn't go through York to get the pass. And it's third down and 11. And here we go. 10:33 left to play in the ballgame. Tied at 14. The loser goes to the house for the winner. The winner of this ballgame moves on to the state semifinals next week. Big play for the Airedale defense. Big play for the Bulldog offense. Third 11 from the Airedale 14. Empty backfield for Martinez. They run Buckner in motion. They're going to hand off to Buckner. Martinez going to keep it, go up the middle. Martinez inside the 10, down to the 6. It'll be fourth down and decision time now for the Whitehall Bulldogs. As the ball is spotted on the Airedale 6, they have to move it to the 2 for the first down. They're going to kick the kick the field goal. So we'll see what kind of kicker they have in the Barnes kid. It's Kyler Barnes. He's a sophomore. We know what kind of kicker Alma has in Olaf Olson.
Mm-hmm.
The holder is Caleb Taylor.
Backup quarterback.
Yep, backup quarterback. Ball is on the right hash. It will be a 24-yard field goal attempt from the right hash for Barnes. Good snap, good hold. The kick is up. It's almost blocked, but it goes through, and it's good.
Oh, wow.
9:44 left to play in the ballgame. Whitehall takes a 17-14 lead over the Airedales as the Airedale defense comes up huge after a short punt. Give the Bulldogs a short field to work with. Alma shuts down and keeps them out of the end zone. They give up the field goal, and I think at this point, guys, Coach Eric Marsh, the defensive coordinator, will take that and pat his defense on the back because they had their backs to the wall on that drive. Now, it's up to Coach Greg Kendrick, the offensive coordinator for Alma. Get his offense in motion. They have not done anything in the third quarter. Whitehall has adjusted to everything that Alma has tried. And I can tell you this, after just talking to Coach Kendrick, just listening to him, I'll put my chips and go all in with Kendrick.
Mm-hmm. And then it's going to come down to that offensive line. And that's where that's been a strength of the Alma team,
yeah,
the whole year.
Purdue tees it up at the 40 for the Bulldogs. Davis and Bailey back deep to receive, standing on their 15. I can't believe they're going to kick it deep. We'll have to wait and see. Here's the kick. They're going to squib it down the middle. It's going to be fielded and fumbled, and Davis falls on it at the 26-yard line. That is twice, you know, and that was Connor Stacy. Usually sure-handed, but Connor Stacy tried to cover the ball at the Airedale 26. He fumbled it, but luckily Davis was right there to fall on top of it. So the Airedale set up shop. First down and 10 from their own 26. They have three timeouts left, 9:41 left to play in the ballgame. It's all up to the Alma offense.
Well, one thing about it, it's not a, because it's turf, it's not a destroyed field, but it's still very wet.
Wildcat package for Davis. Now they move Landon to the right. Play clocks at 4. Davis gets a snap. Davis, they're going to throw it out in the flat. Well, that was Grayson Bailey. Davis caught the football at the 25. That fooled nobody.
No.
They were ready for that. When they broke the huddle, I couldn't tell because they turned sideways, and you really couldn't tell if it's Grayson Bailey or if it's Josh Davis. Now they'll go back on the second down and 9 play, and they'll put Bailey in at quarterback again. Trips to the left side. That's a short side of the field. Alma needs to move the chains. Play clock's at 15. Grayson gets the snap. Grayson trying the left side. Got some blockers. 30, 35, 40, 45. Grayson Bailey down to the 48-yard line. First down to 10, Alma. Great blocking downfield as they run trip wideouts to the left side. And the Airedales have moved the chains. Best-looking play of the second half for Alma.
Yeah, that was wide open. Had the blockers out there. He saw the hole and exploded through it.
Finally, crowd is up on its feet. They have something to cheer about here in the second half. Ball is spotted on the Airedale 47. 8:51 to play in the ball game. Whitehall leads 17-14, their first lead of the game. Grayson, shotgun formation. They run the Wildcat. He'll run it to the right side, to the 45, midfield. Grayson across the midfield stripe to the 49 of Whitehall. And a gain on the play of 4 yards, second down and 6, Alma. Yeah, I know. Mike, I'm waiting for him to throw the late hit and pile an on flag like they did Alma. They just kept piling on Grayson Bailey. Ball is marked at the Whitehall 49. Clock continues to run. 8:23 left in the ball game. Play comes in from the sidelines. Airedales break the huddle at 10. Here we go. On second down and 6. Landon Blair. Shotgun formation for Alma. Everyone tucked in tight in the offense. Now they shift. And Davis will take the snap on the Wildcat. Davis rolling to his left. Looking. Davis trying to bounce outside. He's got a block. Davis 45. Davis to the 40. Landon Blair leading the way. Davis inside the 30. Finally brought out of bounds at the 30 or the 20, 22 yard line. And another penalty flag comes flying. A late hit out of bounds, I think, is what they're going to call. I'm going to wait. I'm not even going to make a call. It looked like one of the Whitehall players come flying in after Davis was on the turf out of bounds. But let's wait and see. They threw the penalty late. Basically after the play was over. But with Alma's luck, it's been an unsportsmanlike against them. But let's see. Let's see the call. Let's wait for the white hat. It's on Whitehall, a personal foul on Whitehall. So that one goes against the Bulldogs for a change. And the penalty was committed
after the play, so it's out of bounds.
So they'll move the ball all the way down to the 12-yard line of Whitehall. First down at 10, Alma. 7:52 left to play in the ball game. Grayson Bailey will take the direct snap. They'll run trips to the left side. He has Connor Stacy, Winfrey, and Davis out there blocking on the left side. To the right side, he has Landon Blair. That's the wide side of the field. First and 10 from the 12. Grayson's going to run to the right side. Follows his blockers, trying to get outside. He's caught from behind and slung to the turf. That's a good defensive play. That was number 27. That was Kyrene Rogers on the tackle. He just got a hold of his shoulder pads and slung him to the turf. They're going to let him say he got back to the line of scrimmage. I don't know how, but that's where they mark it at.
Yeah, he had Seth Coe out there leading the way. He pulled from the left guard position, but he kind of outran him.
Clock is running, 7:20 to play the ball game. 17-14 in favor of Whitehall. Airedale's knocking on the door, second down and 10 from the Whitehall 12. Landon Blair back in at quarterback, Josh Davis to his left. Short side of the field, now they run the Wildcat with Davis. He gets the snap, running it to the right, following his blockers. Davis trying to get outside. Davis hit, and a penalty flag comes flying in late from the backfield, and you can bet that's going to be holding on Alma.
Right in that area.
No gain on the play. And if Whitehall takes the penalty, it will be second down and 20. It was thrown right at the line of scrimmage. This is going to be against Alma. Well, the Airedales and the penalties tonight have just killed some drives. But let's wait on the call. That's what we're... Nope, personal foul. Face mask on Alma.
Wow.
That is a huge call right there.
That's a 15-yarder, isn't it?
15-yard penalty. Yeah. They marked that thing off all the way back to the 27-yard line. The Airedales can pick up a first down at the 2. So this is second down at 25. Corsi and Stacy check in. for the Airedales. Along with Winfrey in the trips package, they'll run Corsi and Stacy to the right side. Play clock's at 10, and here we go. Now they run Davis as a wideout to the left. Empty backfield for Landon. Back to pass. Landon looking. Landon Blair cranking it up, throwing it over the middle. And it's tipped around and almost intercepted by number 11, Cam Robinson of Whitehall.
I don't know what route they were supposed to be running, but they just had seemed like had too many receivers in the same area, and it brought a lot of defenders into the same area.
Had all three of them down there.
Mm-hmm.
Incomplete pass. It'll be third down at 25 from the Whitehall 27. 6:33 left to play in the ball game. 17-14 in favor of Whitehall. Ben Henley checking in for the Airedales. Play clock's at 15. They send Grayson Bailey wide to the left side. High formation, and now Alma's going to take a timeout. That'll be their first timeout of the second half. Some confusion. The play clock was fixing to run out, man. Let's just keep it here. 6:33 to play in the game. Second round of the state playoffs. Airedales trailing 17-14 on the strength of a 24-yard field goal. That is the first lead of the ball game for the Whitehall Bulldogs. What do you think, guys?
Man.
They're getting themselves in the position where is not their strength.
No.
Penalties are killing them.
Penalties are just killing them.
I mean, how do you get a face mask?
When you're on offense, exactly. I don't know.
Well, I saw Landon Blair explaining something to Coach Loffridge, and I'm sure it's about that because he's going to his face mask.
So here we go, coming out of the timeout. It will be third down and 25 from the 27 of Whitehall for the Airedales. They trail by 3, 17-14. Landon Blair, shotgun, empty backfield. Back to pass. Here comes the pressure. Landon lets it go. It's complete at the 17-yard line. It'll be fourth down, and here comes Olaf Olsen to attempt a game-tying field goal. Olaf, an exchange student, kicked a game-winning field goal earlier in the season, and then the game-winning point after in the Forest City game. This one will be a 35-yard field goal from the right hash mark. Right-footed kicker on fourth and 15. Here's a snap. Good snap. Good hold. Kick is up. It's got the distance. And it is good! It's good! And Olaf Olsen kicks a 35-yarder to tie it up at 17. Timeout on the field. 6:21 left to play in the ballgame. We're tied at 17. Back with more from Airedale Stadium right after this.
Simon Family Dentistry proudly supports Alma Airedale's athletics. Look to Dr. Jeremy Simon at Simon Family Dentistry. From tooth-colored fillings, braces, to root canal therapy, to dentures, bridges, and crowns, a visit to Simon Family Dentistry will have you flashing your brightest smile ever. Dr. Jeremy Simon and his caring staff welcome you to Simon Family Dentistry, 191 Highway 64 East in Alma. Open Monday through Thursday from 8 till 5. Behind the Airedales all the way, Simon Family Dentistry, 430-7049.
35-yard field goal from the right hash for Olaf Olsen with 6:21 left to play in the fourth quarter has tied this ball game up. Now it's up to the Airedale defense to come up with another stop here of the Bulldogs. Our guys, like in the UA Fort Smith women's game last night, we had double overtime.
Yep.
Olaf tees it up. They have everybody tucked in tight right in the middle, don't they?
I kick it.
Now they spread them out.
See that ref standing at?
Yeah.
That white hat?
Yeah.
That's right footed.
Olsen tees it at the 40. High kick, long kick. Going to be fielded at the 15. Back to the 20. 25.
Mm.
30. 31-yard line. Let me remind you of something. Whitehall has not fumbled the ball all night. All right? They're due for one. They haven't thrown an interception.
Nope.
They haven't fumbled the ball. They're due for one. They have the ball on the 31. Airedale defense, we'll see. Here we go. First down at 10, Whitehall. They have three timeouts left. They have 69 yards to the end zone. It's 6:15 left to play, and Alma sends in Connor Stacy late. And now Alma's going to have to take a timeout. Boy, they are upset down on the sideline. They had to take their second timeout because they didn't have the right personnel in after the kickoff. And they tried to get Connor Stacy in late, and they still had another player trying to get in there and get somebody off the field before picking up a penalty. And they were forced to take another timeout.
Yep. Coach was not too pleased with that interaction.
No way, man. No way. He's a little unhappy down there. A little fire in the eyes of Doug Lockridge.
Mm-hmm.
Logan Cronister comes on. Here we go. First down and 10 from their own 31. Martinez with Buckner in the backfield. They have two in the pattern on the left side, single wide out to the right on first and 10. Buckner moves to the right now.
Oh, he moved.
The right tackle, Houston Parker of Whitehall, moved, and it'll be first and 15. On their 26.
It's quite a telling deal when you punk yourself in the head.
Yeah.
Kind of lets the referee know you might have done something wrong.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he knew what he did.
Kind of told on himself.
Yeah.
Two wideouts still to the left side. They're lining up in the same set. They have Buckner in the backfield for Martinez, the sophomore quarterback, on first and 15 from their 26. Buckner moves to the right, short side of the field. Now they overload with a motion. They hand off to the tailbauer, to the wide receiver who came in motion from the far side. That was Cam Robinson. Robinson picks up 6 yards, maybe 7 on the play. It will be second down and 8 now as they move the ball out to their own 33-yard line.
Yeah, it was a great open field tackle by Jonathan Polito.
He stayed at home that time. You know, that play had worked for a first down on several carries in that third quarter for him. But Polito stayed at home.
Yeah, and they actually scored on that one, but there was a penalty on the play that brought it out of the end zone.
Two wideouts to the left, nobody in the pattern on the right. Buckner in the backfield with Martinez. We'll see which side he moves on. Now he moves to the right side. That's the short side of the field. They run the same play, the same man in motion. They hand off up the middle. That's Buckner trying to get it outside. 35-40, has the first down. Still on his feet, knocked out of bounds at the 44-yard line. They'll move the chains. A 12-yard carry for Buckner. It'll be first and 10 at their own 45 for the Whitehall Bulldogs. 5:22 left to play. Clock is running. Bulldogs with all three timeouts. We're tied at 17. This is where, if you're Alma, you do not want to let them move the ball down the field. You want to stop them right here,
midfield.
First down and 10 at their own 45. Martinez. Single wide outs either side. Buckner moves to the left. That's a wide side of the field. Martinez hands off to Buckner right up the gut. He's busted into the secondary. Finally got to be hit at the Airedale 40. Man, oh, man, I thought he was going to run for the rest of the day. Nobody in the middle for Alma. They shot everybody to the outside, and they brought the pressure. But that time, the Bulldogs had checked out of it and run Buckner right up the middle.
Yeah, he ran into the back of one of his own players that kind of slowed him down and gave Alma a chance to catch up to him.
Ball is marked on the Airedale 40, first down and 10. Bulldogs, we're tied at 17, 4:30 and counting left to play in the ball game. Wide sides to the right, Martinez, shotgun formation, not been under center all night. They run the same play to the left side. To the Robinson, the wideout.
Man.
Robinson, they had him in the backfield.
Twice.
And could not bring him down. He broke some tackles. And he moved the ball inside the 40 to the 35 of Alma. Thank you. It'll be second down and 5 now for Pine Bluff Whitehall.
One thing about it, we've seen Alma use that play with Grayson Bailey a lot, and it's kind of the same deal, bringing him in motion and handing the ball.
Second down and 5. Martinez at the Airedale 35. Buckner moves to the right. They run a man in motion. That's Robinson. Play action. Wanting to go for it all. Throwing it downfield. Polito is there with him. Mm. And it's broken up at the last minute as Polito and also Jacob Corsi in double coverage had the wideout stride for stride. It will be third down and 5 from the Airedale 35. Clock is stopped. 3:23 to play in the ball game.
Well, they were definitely all in on that. That was the only receiver in a route.
Here we go. As the bells sound in Alma. Third down and 5 from the Airedale 35. Four down territory for the Bulldogs. Two wideouts to the right side. Buckner in the backfield with Martinez. They move him to the left. There's Robinson. They hand off to Buckner up the middle. He has the first down and 4 as he carries it inside the 25 to the 23. And Alma got a finger on him, or he would have been in the end zone.
Mm. I mean, that was just your quick hitter right between the guard and center.
First down and 10 from the Airedale 23. Clock is running. 3:10 left to play in the ball game. They're in field goal range now. Alma with only one timeout left. They have their backs to the wall. See if the defense can pin their ears back and come after them. Martinez, they run Robinson in motion. They hand off to Buckner right up the middle again. Buckner at the 20, brought down at the 19. Gain on the play of 4 yards. Second down at 6. Clock is at 2:40 and counting.
Yeah.
We'll see what Marsh can dial up on defense.
Well, as this has progressed, then that great big offensive line starting to put a little lean on the smaller defense. And now you're seeing some substitutes get a little bit bigger people in the middle.
Second down and 6 from the Airedale 19. Martinez, shotgun formation. They run Robinson in motion. They hand off to Robinson.
The ball went to the ground.
Yep.
Ooh.
And he managed to fall back on it. Fumble. But they picked the football back up, so a lucky break for the Bulldogs of Whitehall. Clock continues to run. Minute 55 left to play. The loss was all the way back to the 23-yard line. Third down at 10, Bulldogs.
Yeah, you had Grayson Bailey blitzing on that one, and he was almost able to get to the fumble.
Third down at 10. Biggest play of the game, biggest play of the year for Alma. Bulldogs looking to pick up a first down to keep this drive going on third and 10. They overload to the right side. They throw the quick out. It's tipped at the line, but it's caught, and it's not going to be enough for the first down. Guys, the ball is out of bounds at the 15. It'll be fourth down and 2 from the 15 as he made the catch. That was Cam Robinson. Now, we're going to line up for a field goal. It's fourth down and 2 from the Airedale 15. A minute 16 left to play in the ball game. And let's wait and see what they want to do. Now, Whitehall has all 3 of its timeouts left. Alma has 1 timeout left.
Yeah, that'd be what, 32-yard field goal?
I don't know if they're, you know, if they go for it. Fine. Yeah, I think they're going to go for it because if they don't make it, it'll make Alma drive the length of the field with, you know, like under a minute to play.
Exactly.
You know, and if Alma can't, can't score, then they'll go to overtime. So now, Whitehall takes the timeout. Alma's going to talk it over as well. We're just going to keep it right here. We're tied at 17. Olaf Olsen hit a 35-yard field goal with 6:21 left to play in the ball game to tie this thing up. Whitehall took the football. It's driven the length of the field. They're at the Alma 15, facing a fourth down and 2. With a minute 16 left to play, they have 2 timeouts left. Alma has 1. There comes the student section. They're coming down to lend a hand.
You bet they are.
And I'm glad to see that.
Yep.
They're getting in this ball game.
There's still a bunch of people in the bleachers and a good turnout for the Whitehall fans, too.
Yep, absolutely. So here we go. Biggest play of the year for both teams. Minute 16 left to play in the game. Fourth down and two from the Airedale 15 for Whitehall. You can bet they're going to give it to their bell cow, Buckner.
Yeah. Just about imagine what play they're going to run here.
Martinez, shotgun. They only have one in the pattern to the left. Martinez, and Buckner left early.
Yeah.
They snapped it, or Martinez left early. They didn't even call that thing.
Wow.
He took off running before the play was even snapped. I can't believe that.
Yeah.
Now look, I'm not a homer. You're not going to listen to me say, they cheated us. That was a blown missed call. Unbelievable.
He was 2 yards still.
He was 2 yards towards the line of scrimmage when the ball before the ball was snapped. And I cannot believe they didn't call that. First down and 10, or first down and goal from the Airedale 10. That just makes me upset. Whitehall with a football. Martin, they move again. Buckner gets a direct snap. He carries it inside the 10. 49 seconds of counting. Unbelievable. The official on the far side had a great look at it. The back judge missed it. The white hat missed it. And Alma takes its final timeout. You guys know me.
Yep.
I call it down the middle. If that had not been a bad call or a bad no call, I wouldn't have said a word. Movement on the left side of the line by the blocking back for Buckner, who took a direct snap on the Wildcat. He was 2 yards towards the line of scrimmage before the ball was snapped, and they didn't throw a single flag on fourth down and two from the Airedale 15. So here's what we have left. I'm going to calm down now. The ball is marked at the Airedale 8. It is second down and goal from the 8. 44 seconds left to play in the game. Whitehall with one timeout left, or two timeouts left. Alma's out of timeouts. They're going to try to grind this thing out. If they don't get in the end zone, they're going to lean on their kicker, Barnes, who's already connected from 24. Second and goal from the 8. Martinez going to keep it. Martinez up the middle. No, that's Buckner. Buckner carries it to the 5. And all he tried to do was move it right into the middle of the hash. He's right directly in the center of the field, and now Whitehall will take a timeout with 33 seconds left to play on third down and goal from the 5.
Yeah. And with that play, he got it right around about just like an extra point.
Mm-hmm. They're going to mark it on the 4. You know what? They put it on the turf earlier in this drive, and it bounced right back to them.
Mm-hmm.
Airedales could get a hand in there and punch this thing out. We're going to go to overtime. You just got to believe. You know, this second half of the season, the Airedales have not given up. I'm not going to give up on them.
No.
Third down and goal from the Airedale 4. 33 seconds left. Whitehall with one timeout left. Alma's out of timeouts. Here come the Bulldogs. Dante Buckner, senior tailback in the Wildcat package. He'll take the direct snap on third and goal from the Airedale 4. And now penalty flag finally flies. They're going to say this on Alma.
Before the snap,
yeah.
Encroachment on the defense. Half the distance to the goal line. Third down.
He's going to sneak up to the line like he's on a blitz. He's going to leave that wide receiver wide open. It's a golf
game. Alma's not got anybody out. Finally, they get Joseph York out on the wideout. Third down and goal from the 2. Buckner. gets the snap. The wideout was moving again on the left side. Again! And they let him score. Watch the replay. I hope they show the replay. He was moving again to the line, towards the line of scrimmage, and again they failed to throw the flag. 31 seconds. I'm tired of talking about it. 31 seconds left to play in the game. Now I'm starting
to
sound.
They're not going
to
replay it.
No, I'm starting to sound like South Sebastian County. It's the last thing I want to sound. Oh wait, no, they're not on the radio anymore. I don't want to say anything else about it. 23-17. Whitehall with a PAT coming up. Barnes, good snap, good hold. Kick is up, and it is good. 24-17. 31 seconds left. Alma's out of timeouts. We'll see what they can dial up here. Airedales have scored with some plays that Coach Kendrick has drawn up that I guarantee you, you're fixing to see a couple right here. This thing's going to go to overtime, man. You just got to believe. You just have to believe. I still don't understand the non-calls. Both times, the lead blocking back moved and started forward. You can't move towards the line of scrimmage until the ball is snapped. This isn't the Canadian Football League. And they've done it twice. They were facing a 4th-and-2 from the Airedale 15, and then 3rd-and-goal. And they've done the same thing twice, and the official still didn't throw the flag. I don't get it. Here we go. Ball is teed up at the 40. 31 seconds left to play. Pulling. Squibb kicks it down the middle. It's going to roll inside the Airedale 10. Davis picks it up. 15. Davis to the 20. Mm. Josh Davis is going to be stopped at the 20-yard line. So the Airedale's 80 yards away from tying this game up with 28 seconds left to play and no timeouts. How more dramatic is this going to be when they score? They score?
Excessively dramatic.
You think I'm going to get excited on this drive?
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Landon Blair, senior quarterback, brings his Airedales out to the line of scrimmage. They send Bobby Winfrey wide to the left side, trips wide to the right side. 1st-and-10 from the 20. 28 seconds left. Landon rolls out to his right, looking downfield, throws. It's over the head of the intended receiver. Jacob Corsi at the 35-yard line. Stops the clock with 22 seconds left to play. Maybe a hook and ladder?
Something like that.
So they got to give Grayson Bailey a shot downfield.
2nd-and-10. 22 seconds left to play. Airedale's out of timeouts. Winfrey, Corsi.
Whitehall's definitely gone into the prevent defense. Yep.
Henley on the right side. Grayson Bailey. Can't see who else. Davis on the left. Back to pass. Looking right. Throwing over the middle. Hook and ladder. They run it. There's Bailey. Bailey to the 30. Bailey to the 35. Bailey. Pitches it back, Landon Blair. He's going to be hit and loses the football. And I think Whitehall's going to recover. That's going to be the season.
Yeah.
They tried to lateral it back. We're going to wait and see. It is Whitehall's football. Alma was trying to keep it alive and lateral it and get it out of bounds. And the storybook ending is going to come to a close for the Alma Airedales.
Yep.
So yeah, Whitehall will move on and take on the winner of the Little Rock Christian win game. They'll just take a knee and run this thing out. That'll be the end of it.
Mm-hmm.
So an impressive second half of the season. Hats off to the Alma Airedales for a great second half of the season and playing with all the heart that they had. But they end up making it to the second round when no one ever gave them a shot to even make it to the playoffs. It comes up with a final score of 24-17 here on a misty, cool night in Alma against the Pine Bluff Whitehall Bulldogs. It was all first half Alma. They led 14-0 at the end of the first half. Whitehall took the lead. It was all Whitehall in the third quarter. They tied it up, took the lead on a field goal. Alma tied it up with 6:21 left in the fourth with a 35-yarder from Olaf Olsen. Whitehall drove all the way down the field. Not even going to talk about the plays. They punched it in and end up winning this football game. You know, yeah. So let's move on to the post-game report. Compliments of Citizens Bank. Successful banking for over 125 years. Guys, it's been a great season. It's been a fun run this year.
Absolutely. Enjoyed it immensely.
0-3 in non-conference. They dropped their first two conference games. 4-1 in the second half of the season to move into the playoffs as the number three seed. Went on the road last week, defeated a very good Forest City team to host this second-round playoff game. They just come up short. They needed some breaks in the second half, a couple of drives in the second half, and you know, guys, for whatever reason, man, I mean, it is what it is.
Yep.
So now we'll move on and watch Stan Flinter's basketball team.
Definitely.
And we encourage each and every listen. And I for all of you that are listening, all of you that are watching the live stream, I apologize for getting upset. I try to call the games down the middle, and I try to give the officials the benefit of the doubt. But when I think that something is, if they had done the same thing and it had benefited Alma, I'd have been just as upset, because I never like to see any official help another team. I like to see the kids win or lose the game on their own.
Right.
So, you know, in my opinion, two penalties could have been called, should have been called in that final drive. Would it have changed the outcome? I don't know. But all I know is I would sure like to have seen it been called like that. But at the end of the day, it wasn't, so we'll just move on. I'm pretty embarrassed right now. I never get on the officials like this. But this is a playoff game, and for the Whitehall Bulldogs, they made the adjustments at halftime. They come out and they won the ball game, man.
Yes, I mean, they did.
You know, it is what it is. But you just hate to see something like that happen.
Right.
And yeah. Anyhow, we'll do it again next year, man.
Next year.
All righty.
David Ray, it's been fun.
Yep.
This will be
been
Ray's
a good run.
This will be Ray's last ball game with me in the booth. 6 years.
6 years.
Yep. 6 years comes to an end. He has everlasting honeydews at home. Actually, Ray and Shay's kids are both they're empty nesters now. They're both in college in Fayetteville. They'll be spending a lot of time on the weekends in Fayetteville. And,
absolutely.
And catching up time with themselves.
Six grandbabies.
So yep. So Mike been a good run this year. Ray's been a good run this year.
Absolutely, Jimmy.
I'm thoroughly embarrassed about complaining about the officials down on that last drive. But
nah.
You know, you just get frustrated. And look, I'm a hired gun here. I'm not hired by Alma. I'm not hired by the school system. I'm hired by Bill Ferris. And I normally don't let my emotions get the best of me. But you know, you like to see the kids win or lose the game, and that's all I'm going to say about it.
There you go.
Done talking about it. Alma comes up short. Whitehall wins the thing 24-17. They're very deserving in this victory tonight. They'll move on to the second round, or the third round, the semifinal matchup against the winner of the Little Rock Christian win game that's going on now. That's going to do it for our Citizens Bank post-game report. Successful banking for over 125 years. Guys, it's been a good run this year.
Yep.
For my broadcast partners, David Ray Sessions, Mike Hess, and I'm Jimmy Haas. Thank you so much for tuning in for another season of Alma Airedale Football. We'll see you again in the fall. How many days until kickoff? I've already counted down, man. have a great winter. Get out and support the Alma Airedale guys and gals in basketball. They've got some good teams, some good players, and they deserve to have your support as well. So. Take care, and we'll see you next fall.
Thank you, Jimmy.
All right, man.
Don't be safe in your travels.
Just a little bit of a change.